Hey folks, it's America's kick-ass career coach. It's me, Mo Faul, back at you for Motivational Monday. I kind of feel like that Monday Night Football thing. Hey everybody, it's time for Motivational Monday. So what would you do if you knew something that other people didn't and you knew it was going to help them? What would you do? Would you shout it from the top of the mountain? Would you publish it in the newspaper? Miliana, would you hold it to yourself and not tell anyone and be so greedy and not want anyone else to have that advantage? What would you do if you knew something that could lift people, help them feel happier, make them richer, make them more successful in every avenue of their lives? What would you do if you knew something like that? I think that you might be like me and be extremely passionate about what this is and how it can help people. I am amazed that not everyone is rushing to learn what I'm doing, because it's not just Miliana and it's not just Shauna and Rhonda and Mary and Stephanie and Debbie, and I could go on and on. The new jobs this week, Rosalyn, Amy, I know you're gonna get your job this week, Marissa. So many women and a few men that I've coached one-on-one, but I'm mostly talking about my kick-ass women who have decided to say yes to themselves and within weeks landing jobs after not being employed for, one woman, we're still working on it, 4 years unemployed. One woman since last December. She starts work tomorrow. 11, almost 12 months of unemployment. Why wait so long? How about a woman who's been in the same company for 12 years? Overlooked, undervalued. She's not speaking up, and she starts to be in her power and be in full alignment and do the consciousness work that I teach and coach on. And all of a sudden, magically, she gets an email from the CEO, the president, and her direct boss, the vice president, saying how awesome she is and what a valuable asset she is to the company. And then, bam, a raise. Yeah, just like that. Because it's called stepping into your power, and your power is your soul. That's why, if you haven't seen my webinar yet, Bring Your Soul to Work, we'll put the link down here in the post. Bring Your Soul to Work is guaranteed to have better results for you, not only at work, but hey, Miliana, you can rock and roll on this one. In every aspect, women are better wives, better mothers, better partners, better sisters, daughters, better coworkers, better friends, because they are better. So I have a question for you. What are you waiting for? What in the blue blazes are you waiting for? Oh, another month, Mo, of being miserable and my life sucking and my boss treating me like crap. Let's just wait another month, because I really, really want to be beaten down a little bit longer. And then when I can't stand it anymore and it's like a chokehold and I'm grasping for my last breath, Maybe then I'll bring my soul to work. Or will you? Here's my experience. My experience is this, and this is under the title of Why the Frick Do You Wait? Yes, you can quote me on that. Why the frick? Why do you wait to feel good? Oh, thanks, Miliana. So why do you wait? What the heck? If I tell you I have exactly what you need to feel better about yourself, to feel better about everything you do. Hey, Tracy. Hey, Jean. To feel better at work and to do more, get paid more, be seen as your awesome self. If I said to you, I can do that with you, would you say to me, no, I think I'll sit here in my misery and wait because I like being unhappy and gosh, you know what? People who are at work are unhappy too. And that's what we talk about at work. So if I was happy, what would I talk about at work? And you know what? If I came home with a lot of energy and the kids needed stuff, then I'd have to be a happy mom. You know what? I'd rather be the mom who flops on the couch, doesn't have time for her kids, and her kids are always saying, Mom, you never do anything fun anymore. Have you heard those words? I don't know about you, but I did. I heard those words all the time. And you know what my wake-up call? Double mastectomy. In October, I did a 5-day series on my journey in breast cancer and double mastectomy. It wasn't pretty. Still, 9 years later, I'm still crying about it. I'm still shedding tears of the loss and the grieving and the intense trauma. If that's what you're waiting for, I think you better take a look at what your priorities are. If you're waiting to be slammed up against the wall with cancer or trauma or a car accident or a divorce or a job loss. I remember one woman several months ago, it was sometime this summer, we're talking on one of my free clarity calls. And from time to time, you'll get me. So book your call. You never know. You might get me in person. And then you better look out because we're going to get clear. We're going to get real clear. I've got two wonderful career breakthrough strategists who are going to take care of you. But on this particular call this summer, a woman who's a paralegal is describing to me how she lost her previous job. She's in a new job. It's not feeling really good. They're not really valuing her. She's making about 20 grand less than she was making. And she's feeling like she's at the end of her rope at that company, that law firm. And I said, you better start pulling out the recruiters and getting the resume launched and looking at jobs if this is what you're feeling. Because if you're feeling it, it's coming down. Okay? Hey, Kimmy. So what she did was she said yes to herself. She joined my kick-ass workshop. And within the first week, hey, it's no surprise or no mystery that my workshop is an investment. In the first week, she loses the job. Fired. Yep. Told you I produce magic. But what the magic was, she knew she was going to get fired. It was just a matter of time. What the magic was, is she reached out to me and my coach who works with me, Jean, and she got taken care of. She got coached through the problem. And we said, hey, have you reached out? Have you been talking to recruiters? Pick up the phone, get calling. Well, she called one of them and they said, hey, an opportunity just happened today. Can you be available for an interview this afternoon? She goes, yep, I'm there. Had she not been in the coaching program, she wouldn't have had the support. And you know what? I don't think she'd be calling people the day she got fired. She would have been sad, depressed, maybe talked to a friend, maybe went to a movie. She wouldn't have taken action, I can guarantee you, because I've been fired or laid off 6 times in my life. I know how it feels. When you have support and coaches who care about you, they're going to lift you up. No matter how big or how small the assault, you're going to get lifted up. And she got lifted up. She took action. That recruiter booked her for an interview that afternoon. She got the job for a new paralegal job, paying her more money than the one she got fired from within 24 hours of getting fired. Now, I'm good. The coach who works for me, Jean Callahan, is good. The group support is freaking awesome. Better than your best friends because it's 40, 50, 60 women from around the world who are just like you, Why do people not make changes when they know they need to? Because they're afraid. They're afraid that things won't pan out for them. They're afraid to be a failure. They're afraid to be looked at stupid. They're afraid to waste time and money. Hey, Lisa. I understand. I've had a coach for 17 years. Rena, nice to see you. And I know what it's like to rely on someone who has some answers and who have seen things that I've never seen. And let me tell you, I see so much for the work I do in my coaching, kick-ass coaching program. And I know what I was able to do for myself, which is why I have this kick-ass coaching program. It's everything I did in my career to further my career and overcome the obstacles of getting fired, passed over for promotions, feeling out of alignment, feeling inauthentic, speaking up at meetings and not being heard. I have been there. Every single problem or mistake I've ever coached on, I've done. I've been there. Okay, there was one that I have never done before, and that was a beautiful woman in my workshop last year. One of her coworker's sons committed suicide while he was on the phone with his mother. My kick-ass coaching client's her boss. As you can imagine, that workplace was in shambles. It was traumatic for everyone to see that woman go through such a devastating traumatic loss and shock. My client was able to support her coworker, her direct report, because my client had support and coaching and advice on the right things to do. And she knew how to show up for her direct report because she was aligned. She had learned how to bring her soul to work. So she was able to help this woman be the mother and the wife that she needed to be. That's kick-ass coaching. When you have the right support, you're freaking awesome. And if you're not there right now, if you're in fear, if you're in victim mode, if you're feeling lousy, let's take care of it now. What's one more month? Okay, so Mo, it's the holidays. I got a lot going on. Yeah, guess what? Your best person, your best self during the holidays is someone who's coached. That's someone who's aligned. We went through this with the folks who've been in the workshop during the Thanksgiving holiday here in the U.S. And let me tell you, Thanksgivings were much less traumatic. Not only that, don't you want to lay seeds for what your 2018 is without waiting a whole nother month? If you've got a $20,000 increase potentially coming your way and you wait a month, that's $1,600, $1,700, $1,800 a month. And if you don't get started now, so usually a new job gain in my workshop is 8 to 10 weeks. The workshop's 12. So I take someone from the beginning through the first few phases, although we do have a woman who's graduating last week. She landed 2 jobs in 12 weeks. I know, sounds amazing. She left a very underpaid, very oppressive environment very early on in the workshop. Within 3 weeks, she had a new job, paying her better. She thought it was gonna be awesome, but they were so understaffed, so under-resourced. She couldn't do any, it was horrible. So she ends up looking for a new job, landing that second job. It's freaking awesome. It's her dream job. She's making more money. She's having fun. She is loving it. She's totally, totally kicking ass. I think that might be a record, 2 jobs in 12 weeks. And both of them felt pretty darn good. But the first one just wasn't enough resources, and she was really out on a limb with trying to get stuff done there. So had she not been in the workshop, she probably would have stuck through that first job. You know that whole loyalty thing? She would be like, well, I'll give it another shot. I'll maybe stay here for a year, and if it's not working out by then, and meanwhile her earnings would have been like this, and meanwhile her happiness would have been like this, and she has a young son at home, and she would have been an overstressed out, overworked mom, and she wouldn't have been having fun with her son. I see this all the time. What are you waiting for? Lisa, you know how this is. You waited a couple of days, then we kind of like, I stayed on you. What are you waiting for? If you are not happy in your job, you're not happy in your life. Guarantee. And if you're fooling yourself about that, then you're fooling yourself about that. Because I can guarantee you that if you're not happy at work, you are not a happy person. There is no happy person rolling around being a victim at work. Doesn't work. Can't be. When you're freaking awesome, kick-ass, and you bring your soul to work, you're awesome at work and you're awesome at home. One of the women who just graduated from my kick-ass coaching program is an IT, and it was her job after getting laid off. She was making less money. She was in an undervalued position. Her boss didn't give her even the time of day. He didn't even know what she did. She said, I need to leave this place. It was a big company with lots of opportunity. So she was like, I need to leave this place. I need to find a new job. And she's in a big city in the Southwest. And I thought, okay, let's take a look at who you are and what really fits for you. Those are the first two modules in my kick-ass coaching program. Let's not jump to any conclusions. No one's beating you down. You're not in a totally toxic environment. You're making decent money, keeping the food on the table and keeping things going. So let's not jump from the frying pan to the, I just lost that analogy. You know what I'm saying. So she did the work. She showed up bigger. She showed up more aligned at work. And guess what happened? Oh, hey, we're going to put you on this special project. Oh, nice job you did in that meeting describing this and this. Oh, hey, we're going to send you to this really important meeting and we want you to present there. Oh, hey, we want to put you in a new department now that's in charge of really special projects. She got super excited about where she's working. She got seen. She got recognized. She owned the room and she practiced all of that in the kick-ass coaching program. She didn't wait. She didn't wait for a couple more months and more misery. And by the way, she was then started to call by recruiters for new job opportunities. So when you're aligned and you're totally kick-ass and you're bringing yourself to work, you match up with higher vibrational experiences, people, events, opportunities. And you know what? Some of those friends that bring you down start to go by the wayside. Start to not really be too interested. And you, when you call them, you're not interested in talking to them because you feel like crap when you're talking to them. And you know what? When you're used to feeling like crap, it's okay to talk to a friend who makes you feel like crap because you don't know the difference. When you start feeling awesome, you stay away from the people that pull you down. Trust me, if you're not feeling good today, if you're in victim, underpaid, undervalued, if you are miserable in your work, you've got friends who help you stay there. Guarantee it. I guarantee it. You've got friends who help keep the story going of how bad your boss is, of how horrible your work is, how bad the company is, how low your pay is. You've got friends who agree with you. And that's what keeps the story going. So you want to wait one more month of having that? You want to wait several more months? What are you thinking? So back to my question at the beginning of this. If you knew how to fix a problem for a friend or a loved one or even someone that you saw across the street that you felt compassion for, if you knew how to fix something that was making them hurt, don't you have an obligation to go get at it right now and help them? If you saw someone pinned under a car, aren't you gonna run across the street and do whatever you can to lift that car to have them slide out? Of course you will. Me too. So when I see women pinned under the car of a bad job, sometimes a bad marriage, over-controlling men in both, sorry guys, it's just what happens. If you see a woman pinned under that car, aren't you going to lift it up and drag them out and say, whew, save you from the burning flames, and then within minutes the car explodes and you're like, oh, thank goodness we did that just in time. Every now and then the women who I talk to on my clarity calls who say no to me, either because they can't imagine investing themselves or they have an over-controlling spouse who doesn't want them to be better or feel better, I guess. I don't know why they say, why would you do that, honey? or they just can't see themselves having more, even though the inner being is screaming. That's why you're on a call, because you know something's not working. And I'm really good at getting people through their fear. Trust me, I'm a really good coach. I know the psychology of moving people from pain through their fear into the possibilities. If I didn't know how to do that, I wouldn't be able to help a single soul. And I've helped hundreds of souls over the past several years doing this work. First, I saved my soul, and then hundreds of others. And when I reach back out to call women who said no, it's not a pretty picture. When you have that why in the road, when you have the opportunity to say yes to yourself or no, and you choose no, what do you think happens to your vibrational equivalency? It goes down. So now you're attracting a lower level affinity pattern. Things get worse. I wish it wasn't so, but it is. I've called dozens and dozens of women after the clarity call, and their lives are worse. And at this point, moving them into supporting the idea of something better almost is impossible. It's like, I saw you with a sprained ankle and you kept walking on it, and now it's almost like you're gonna have to have that foot removed in order to get to the next level. Not to be too gross or gory, I am a nurse, so these analogies just come to me. I've had women who have lost their jobs and not had the support of my coaching and my program. I've seen women get divorced. I've seen women get completely undervalued. I've seen women get pay taken away from them, and they stay in that job. What's up with that? Women around the world, hear my plea. If you are underpaid, underemployed, underrecognized, if you're not happy with your work, pick up the phone, pick up your computer, book your call with me or my team. Let's get you out of that. Let's lift you up. Let's take you out from underneath that car. I want to lift your life up and help you. Come on. Waiting one more month could be disaster. I had breast cancer 9 years ago, like I said earlier, and I waited too long to get my shit together. I waited way too long. It took me another 5 years, although at that point I was aligned with my work and I was doing great things with my teams and with the companies I was with. But eventually I knew there was something more. And so 3 years ago, I made the leap. I'm not suggesting that that's the right leap for anyone else. As a matter of fact, I might be one of the few people out there who's telling you that I want to help you find a job that's aligned with you. I want to help you bring your soul to work so that you can land your dream job. There's a lot to be had in the workforce. There's a lot of great compensated companies. There's a lot of great fun and using your talents and working with teams and being a part of something bigger than yourself. It's freaking fantastic to have that dream job, to love Mondays. I was just meeting with a client of mine on Saturday. I spoke to a group of her colleagues in this huge multinational company. And I gave some of my pearls of wisdom, if you will. And here I see a room full of women who are nodding like this. They don't know how to speak up and own the room. They're not maximizing their value. They're underpaid. They don't know how to get ahead. I'm telling you what, don't wait any longer. Shauna, my badass woman, Shauna, she'll tell you how it goes. So Shauna, it's been 14 months since we've known each other. And we won't let out too many secrets, but wow, has your life gotten aligned? Has your life gotten so freaking aligned and amazingly forward for you? Ladies and gentlemen, one last time. If you're not where you want to be with your career, take a step toward yourself. And book your clarity call and get going. I have the answers for you. I know exactly how to take your soul where it is right now, pinned up against that car. Ah, help me, help me. You don't know how to get out from underneath the car. I get it. I was so there. Thank you, Shauna. So worth the investment. I want to lift that car up, and I'll do it. And I want to drag your body and your soul out from underneath that car and send you forward into your beautiful, magnificent self. Into your beautiful, magnificent soul. Say yes to yourself. You are the only person who's in charge of your destiny. And it only comes from you. So, I have three steps that I wrote about in my Motivational Monday. I can't be more passionate about this. You wait for something to be right to choose for yourself. It will never happen. I had a woman this summer whose son was tragically hit on a motorcycle near death in the ICU for weeks. She said, Mo, I wouldn't have been able to keep myself together and be the supportive mother I needed to be for my son this summer if it weren't for this program and your coaching. That's what I got going on. Okay? Lisa Bolin, so true. No one will do it for you. So here's the three steps. Decide that you're worth it. Your soul and your future is priceless. There is so much for you in the world of wonderfulness, in the world of alignment, in the world of your soul. There is so much for you. Decide you are worth it. A little side note here. If you're in a marriage that doesn't support your moving forward and being a better you, you got some issues there. Yes, you do. I'm calling it like I'm seeing it. I see it all the time, unfortunately. Number two, say no to the struggle. There is no reason why you need to struggle and suffer through life. That's not what it's meant for. I know you were probably raised with parents or grandparents or other family members or whatever family of origin you had that taught you how to struggle and how to be against the corporation and bosses are nasty and people with money are evil. Cut it out. End the struggle. It's too much energy. It's not helping you. Being on the struggle bus, suffering, it's not helping you at all. Now, what it is doing is it's getting you backwards energy. So you're getting attention by being a struggler and a sufferer. Oh, I'm getting attention. You probably don't know that that's what you're doing, but that's what you're doing. That's your way of getting energy. This is an energetic universe in which we live. And if you aren't filling up your own bucket, you're going to be demanding it and pulling it from others. That's what struggle and suffering does. It pulls energy from others so that you can get filled up. And guess what? It never happens ever. You must fill up your own bucket. So get off the struggle, get off the suffer, take responsibility, decide you're worth it. Number three, do it now. Don't wait. Give yourself the best 2017 because it's the year you said yes. Do it now. Say yes to yourself. Look, there's lots of coaches out there. I'm not saying I'm the only one. Clearly I'm not. But I'm going to put my results up next to almost anyone. Almost. Did I say almost? I'm putting my results up next to anyone. There's a tribe of women on this planet who have owned their destiny, who have found their soul and their power, and they are leading lives that are beyond their wildest dreams. Do it now. Make 2017 that year you said yes. Make 2018 the best year ever. And you know what? The women who've been working with me for years, every year is the best year ever. And the better it gets, the better it gets. I'm going to be in DC working with a small group of my clients, and we're creating futures. We are creating consciousness and futures. And I'm going to be conducting a retreat for only my clients in May, where out of that retreat this past May, so many new jobs, new cars, better relationships, more aligned people. Bring your soul to work. Do it now. For yourself first, and for your spouse, partner, family, everything gets better when you're better. Go ahead and be that higher version of you. You're probably going to need help doing it. I am here to help you get there. This is Mo Faul, America's kick-ass career coach and the creator, author, and inventor of the Bring Your Soul to Work approach to land your dream job. It's happening every day, folks. You are worth it. Get off the struggle bus and say yes to yourself now. Over and out. I will see you next time. This is Coach Mo. Haha, everything does get better indeed, Miliana. Thanks everyone for being here. Your souls are beautiful. Keep showing them. Bye now. MoFaul.com.